In this video, we will discuss how to calculate the bandgap energy from UV-Vis reflection data using Origin. Such data is obtained from a diffused reflectance spectrometer, in short DRS, or from a UV-Vis spectrometer in reflectance mode. I will suggest watching the above-mentioned video in which I have explained the basic terminologies regarding the bandgap calculations using the Tauc plot. This is the Tauc equation, where alpha is the absorption coefficient. For the DRS data, we will replace alpha with the Kubelka Munk function, f of r. F of r infinity is called the Kubelka Munk function, which is itself a ratio of the absorption coefficient k and the scattering coefficient s, such that both are in meter inverse. That is, F of r is equal to k over s, k is equal to 1 minus r square, and s is equal to 2r. Where r infinity is the percent reflectance obtained in the DRS data. The subscript infinity denotes sufficient thickness of the sample layer that is thick enough to completely hide the support on which the desired material is placed or deposited. However, before proceeding towards the calculations, we will have to elaborate briefly about the Kubelka Munk theory, its limitations, and the simplest assumptions on which the theory is based upon. In 1931, Kubelka and Munk proposed a system of differential equations based on a simplified model of light propagation in a dull painted layer that is parallel to a plane. The medium is considered isotropic and homogeneous. However, a few optical heterogeneities exist which disperse the incident light. There is no specular reflection as the sample is considered dull and that the surface bounding the colored layer are plane, parallel, and infinite, so that there are even no boundary effects. In addition, the absorption and scattering coefficients k and s are supposed to be constant for all thicknesses of the layer. Finally, polarization and spontaneous emission in both fluorescence and phosphorescence are also ignored in this theory. As a result, the inadequacies of the 1931 theory are due to the assumptions set down in it, which do not correspond to the practical cases and thus often give not very satisfactory results. Among others, the assumption that only two opposite fluxes coexist is not representative of reality, and the new formula obtained by Kubelka in 1948 lessens this major drawback. It has also been assumed that the medium is homogeneous, which makes the model insufficient for a substantial number of practical applications. The particle size is not taken into account either. Having all these things in mind, we can now proceed towards the calculations in Origin. Let us open the DRS data of titanium dioxide nanoparticles. The first column shows the wavelength in nanometer, while the second column shows the percent reflectance. The very first thing we should do here is to normalize the reflectance to 1 by dividing it by 100. Now, we will calculate the absorption coefficient k in meter inverse. Which is 1 minus r whole square. So we can write it as 1 minus column c whole square. Next, we will find scattering coefficient S in meter inverse, which is 2R. So we can write 2 times column D. Now, it is time to calculate F of R, which is K over S, so we can write it as column D over column E. We are now ready to calculate F of R times energy. In units of electron volt centimeter inverse with a power 1/2 by multiplying column F in G with power 1/2. Similarly, we can calculate F of R times energy in units of electron volt centimeter inverse with a power 2 by multiplying column F in G with power 2. Now, in order to plot H nu versus F of R H nu power gamma, where gamma is 1/2 and 2, we change column D to x-axis. It is evident that there is a possibility of having both the direct and indirect band gaps, that is, the band gap is having a quasi-direct band gap character. As the possibility of the indirect band gap is comparatively more prominent, so let us calculate this one. By extrapolating the linear region onto the x-axis, gives the band gap energy close to 3 electron volt, we can report this as an inset in the DRS data. Thank you for watching the video.